सरस्वत्यै नमः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः ॐ समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम् शिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये व्यासं वसिष्ठनस्तारं शक्तेर्पौत्रमकल्मषं पराशरात्मजं वन्दे शुकतातं तपोनिधिं व्यासाय विष्णुरूपाय व्यासरूपाय विष्णवे नमो वै ब्रह्मनिधये वासिष्ठाय नमो नमः वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् नमो वसिष्ठाय महाव्रताय पराशरं वेदनिधिं नमस्ये नमोऽस्त्वनन्ताय महोरगाय नमोस्तु सिद्धेभ्य इहाक्षयेभ्यः नमो परमं परेषां देवेषु देवं वरदं वराणां सहस्रतीर्षाय नमः शिवाय सहस्रनामाय जनार्दनाय So we saw Ayati's story up to some extent. So having received the special blessings from Shukracharyaji, a permission that I should be in a position to exchange my old age with anybody's young age, youthfulness. I asked my sons, you must also give me permission, whoever accepts or to this exchange offer, he alone will be made as king. So Shukracharya gave permission for that. So theek hai, aise karo. Then Yayati asked, first he went to eldest son Yadu, from whom Yadavas were born. No? He said, Yadu beta, you are born from me only. Now I request you, you give me your youthfulness to me. You take my old age from me. For only for 1,000 years. Afterwards again I give back my whatever, I take back my old age from you and give back your youth. I wanted to enjoy life. I have plenty of desires left. So kindly help me. Yadu said, Papa, old age is very difficult. Number one. For what purpose? For eating and drinking. अब देखिए मजा मजा आएगा. अब यदु बोलते हैं, बाल पूरा सफेद हो जाएंगे, मूंछ भी सफेद हो जाएगा, दाढ़ी बढ़ाए तो दाढ़ी भी सफेद हो जाएंगे. अच्छा, and old age shatters completely. एक बार यू नो बुढ़ापे में भाई भाई लगता है. अकेला सो भी नहीं सकते, अकेला उठ भी नहीं सकते, अकेला कहीं जा भी नहीं सकते. बाबा डर 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 से जीना पड़ेगा. एंड ऑल ओवर द बॉडी रिंकल्स विल कम एंड बॉडी विल नॉट हैव एनी शेप एंड साइज एंड ऑल दैट, यू नो इट गोज आउट ऑफ शेप. पता नहीं क्या क्या होता है. एंड देयर विल नॉट बी एनी स्ट्रेंथ टू एंजॉय. आई वॉन्ट टू एंजॉय लाइफ. देयर फॉर आई एम सॉरी, I don't want this exchange offer. You continue to be in old age. Don't ask me. beta, we will take old car, useful for me. Or I will purchase scooter, scooty without a gear. Tu bhi use kar lo, main bhi use karunga. To beta kya bolta hai? Hat ja, nikal jao yahan se. To scooty chahiye, scooty without gear. Mujhe latest bike chahiye, bike with gears. Nahi beta, hamara bhi kaam ho jayega, tera bhi kaam ho jayega. Mante nahi koi. Nothing doing. You old man, apne liye aap aur ek gaadi khareed le, mere liye naye naye gaadi. Speed vehicle I want. So Yayati was not happy. He cursed his child and said, your children will never be eligible to rule the kingdom. Ye mera curse hai. Ja. Then he went to Turvasu, second son. Same thing repeated. Beta, 1000 years ke liye. He said, I don't want old age, daddy. Why? Because no, old age is the one which destroys one's ability to enjoy different objects of life. I can't marry. I can't enjoy anything in life. I can't have children. It puts totally an end to one's own strength and also shape of the body. And moreover, it destroys one's own buddhi and prana shakti also. Shatya gaya. Meaning what? Buddhi. Gaya. Saar saal ke baad? Sad gaya. Main maalum hai, sad gaya bolta hoon, isiliye. Buddhi sad gaya. Shatya gaya, nahi, sad gaya. He said, बुद्धि भी नष्ट हो जाती है, प्राण शक्ति भी नष्ट हो जाती है, पता नहीं, याद नहीं रखता, बार बार पूछना पड़ता है तेरा नाम क्या है. इट्स वेरी टू पेनफुल ना टू ओल्ड एज के साथ, वेरी पेनफुल. अब बताना एक बात, क्या क्या बात करते हैं, तो हम भी बात करते हैं उनसे. मजा, यू कांट स्पेंड टाइम विद देम. इवन 5 मिनट्स बैठोगे ना, हाँ चलो दादाजी मैं चलता हूँ. बैठो क्या जाते, बैठो ना बैठे बैठो. यानी मुझे काम है. काम क्या? काम है मेरे अलावा मेरे सुंदर रूप देखते हुए बैठो. कोई भी इंटरेस्टेड नहीं है. चले, इट गोज देयर फॉर माई प्राण शक्ति ऑल्सो गोज अवे, बॉडी ऑल्सो गोज आउट ऑफ शेप. हेंस आई डोंट वॉन्ट. ये याद कर्स्ड हिम दैट योर संतति विल बी डिस्ट्रॉयड कंप्लीटली. Yayati went to third son, Druhya, his name is. Beta, repetition again, same thing. Third son said, kya baat karte ho aap? I don't want to take your old age. Why? Voice become shattered. Baat bhi nahi kar sakte hain. Parkinson disease. Shakes whole body. And भोग इज नॉट पॉसिबल इन ओल्ड एज. आप मुझे आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू टेक. ये याद ए कर्स्ड हिम दैट यूर विशेस विल नेवर बी फुलफिल्ड. जाओ, शाप शाप सबको. फोर्थ सन इज अनु. एक्चुअली ये आजकल ने कभी हमेशा सृष्टि में बड़े लोग, जब बच्चे बड़े लोगों का बात नहीं मानते ना, ऐसा ही गर्त हो जाते हैं. फिर सत्यानाश हो जाओ, फिर संतान भी. तो बड़े होने के बाद जब तुम्हें तेरे बेटे तुमसे ऐसा व्यवहार करेगा तब पता चलेगा. ये सब एक्चुअली कर्सी है ना. तू मेरा पेट में से निकला गर्धव, गर्धव गर्धव में डोंकी. तेरे बेटे ऐसे, तेरे संतान में ऐसे हो जाएगा. सेम एज इट इज डायलॉग आर रिपीटेड. तेरा धन नाश हो जाए, हॉरिबल. अनु सेड, महाराज जी आप ये बात सुनिए, आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू टेक ओल्ड एज. वाई? ओल्ड पीपुल टेक फूड इन रॉन्ग टाइमिंग्स. इनको समय पर भूख नहीं लगती, अचानक भूख लगती है. ब्रेकफास्ट का समय 8 बजे या 9 बजे, वो तब भूख नहीं लगती, 11 बजे भूख लगती है. नहीं तो ब्रेकफास्ट टाइम और लंच टाइम. लंच टाइम 12:30 बजे तब भूख नहीं लगती, 3 बजे भूख लगती है. रात को नहीं खाते, 12 बजे उठा जाते भूख लग रही है. Old age is such a horrible thing. And they always remain impure. Why? Saliva comes here. They can't clean their hair properly. Pani peete peete, half a glass pani, shareer ke upar hi. Khana khate khate, some khana will on the body only. Dhoondna padta hai actually. You have to put the head and the mouth in one angle and hand in one angle and jodi yoga. Karamukha yoga, it is called. Karamukha yoga means karam in hand. Mukha is karamukha yoga. Kahan jata hai pata nahi. Head also shakes, hand also shakes. To bring them in balance is a high problem. It's very difficult. Ek angle mein lana, khana lana. To koi sir pakadna hai, koi haath pakadna hai, koi par baad mein ghusana hai. Difficult hai. Wrong, they always remain impure. Nahate rahe kabhi kabhi, old age. नहा भी नहीं सकते हैं, वहीं का वहीं टॉयलेट, वहीं का वहीं बाथरूम, बॉडी इज नॉट कोऑपरेटिंग, यू डू नो स्ट्रेंथ एंड दे विल नॉट बी इन ए पोजिशन टू डू एनी अग्नि कार्यम. मॉर्निंग गेटिंग अप स्वाहा, नो अग्नि कार्यम, देयरफॉर आई डोंट वांट इट. ययाति गॉट एंग्री एंड सेड, ही कर्स्ड हिम सेइंग दैट यूअर प्रोजेनी विल डाई एट वेरी यंग एज. Job. Last one was Puru. Puru accepted the offer. He said, there is nothing greater blessing than to accept one's own father's wish. Aap guru saman hai, pita hai, guru hai. So whatever you say, I'll accept it. And it is the duty of the son to follow instruction of the father. Oh daddy, don't worry. Karke 2-3 slokas are there. He is a putra, he is a son who accepts and how he lives, etc. Then the Yayaki was so happy and he said, I am blessing you. All the citizens of your kingdom will enjoy their lives fully every moment. This is my blessings and this is my boon. And afterwards, he remembered Shukracharyaji and he exchanged his old age, gave the old age to his son Puru, P-O-O-R-U, Puru. And he became youth. Now, the moment he became youth, he started enjoying life. But what is happening in him is, every day he is more worried that the end of 1000 years is coming. Every day he is calculating. अभी आज 3 घंटे हो गए, 5 घंटे रहे, अभी क्या 900 ईयर्स ओनली आर लेफ्ट. सो एवरी टाइम द काल इज डिमिनिशिंग, इज कॉन्स्टेंटली वरीड दैट आई एम लूजिंग माई टाइम. हॉरिबल. एंड यू स्टार्टेड काउंटिंग मिनिट्स एंड हवर्स, यू वाज एंजॉयिंग बट विद ए फियर दैट ही इज लूजिंग इट. जल्दी जल्दी भोगना है, जल्दी जल्दी सब कुछ करना है. वही समय का अंत होने वाला है. एस्पेशली ऑल द ओल्ड पीपल विल हैव सेम टेंडेंसी अगेन. जल्दी जल्दी घर खत्म करना है, जल्दी जल्दी बेटी की शादी करनी है, जल्दी जल्दी बेटा का शादी होना है, जल्दी जल्दी हम ये करना है, जल्दी जल्दी बद्रीनाथ यात्रा होना है, जल्दी जल्दी रामेश्वरम करके आ जाएंगे, जल्दी जल्दी वहां जाएंगे, जल्दी जल्दी यहां जाएंगे. ईयर आफ्टरवर्ड वी आर बिकमिंग ओल्डर एंड ओल्डर. पता नहीं क्या होगा अगले साल, पता नहीं क्या होगा. दिस वरी ग्रिप्स. So this worry is there that samay ka ant ho raha hai, we are fast approaching towards death, and therefore after even 1000 years of enjoyment he was still not happy with all the kinds of bhoga he had for 1000 years. He was not happy. Then he said, he called his son Puru, excellent slokas oft quoted, so brilliant experience. Every Mahatma quotes this slokas, excellent slokas in this section. He says, hey my dear son, please remember that yatha kamam yathotsaham yatha kalam arindama sevita vishaya putra yavvanena maya tava tava yavvanena maya. I enjoyed through youth, your youthfulness, yadechaya, whatever I want, yatha kamam, whatever a bhoga I wanted to, yatha utsaham, with a lot of utsaha, I enjoyed yatha kalam, as long as I want. long as I want, yato with inspiration, as long whatever bhoga I want, sevita vishayaha, I have really enjoyed this life. Still, this is the most famous sloka. This one is oft quoted. Najatuh kama kamanam upabhogena shamyati avishah krishna vatmeva bhuyayeva abhivardhate. This is the most oft quoted sloka by every Mahatma. This is the Yayati's experience. He says, Najatu kama kamanam upabhogena shamyati. The thirst to enjoy the worldly objects will never come to an end by enjoying them. चले उसका भी भोग ले, इसका भी खा ले, इसका भी एक बार तृप्ति दे दे, फिर इसका भी अंत हो जाएगा, तो एक बार रसगुल्ला खा ले, फिर तो मन शांत हो जाएगी, नहीं होगा। न जातो काम हा कामानाम उपभोगे ना उपभोग कामानाम उपभोगे ना न शाम्यति। Thirst, desire, trishna will never end through experience. How? He says, how upabhoga na shamyati? Sloka is very interesting thing is that havisha krishna vartmeva bhuyayeva abhivardhate. Just as in order to put off the fire, you are putting more ghee inside. What will happen to fire? Fire rages. More and more fire comes out of the oven. So more ghee you put, more fire comes out. So therefore, my dear son, it is like a foolishness that I never now understood that desires will never end through bhoga. Iske baar ek baar bhog le, iska hant ho jayega, ek kabhi nahi hoga. Ek kabhi nahi hoga. Therefore it says, yat prithivyam vrihiyavayam vrihiyam yavam hiranyam pashavastriyah ekasyapi aparyaptam tasmat krishnam parityajet. If, he says, prithivya, total prithivi, earth, vrihiyavam, along with the corn and all these great, great, food particles, food, and also hiranyam, gold, pashavaha, cattle, striyaha, women. If all the people who are there on the earth, if they are given to one person, ekasyapi na paryaptam, they are not sufficient for even one person. Sab sare de rahi hai prithvi mein, jitne hai bhog lo, that is not enough for bhoga. Tasmat, therefore, trishnam parichyaje. Therefore, one has to give up the desire itself. Parichyaja, parichyaja is not suppression. Parichyaja means giving it up. There is no end for these desires. No end. हमारा है ना जीवन में वस्तु सेकरणम means collection of objects. It has become a hobby. The amount of articles we collect, objects we collect, kapde that we collect, jute we collect, mind boggling. And we talk of high Vedanta. Nonsense. Nonsense. What is sign of Vairagya? Living with minimum. Happily. Not suffering, cursing oneself. इसका अंत नहीं है. चश्मा का फ्रेम ऑल्सो वी चेंज फॉर एवरी सिक्स मंथ्स. नॉट वन चश्मा, टू थ्री चश्मा. नो एंड फॉर दिस. इसे there is no end. Ya duschaja durmatihi bhiya durmatir bhiya na jīryati jīryatah yo asau pranantiko rogastan drushnam jajatas sukham. What is drushna? He says, that which is most difficult to renounce, to give up among the dull-witted, mandabuddhi, durmati people ke liye, jo atyant khatine tyagne mein, that which is difficult to be given up, and that which never becomes old, na jiryati jiryataha, that is so Subhashitam also is there. Vayameva jirnaha, patushna will never end. I become old, my body become old, and I am burnt, but my desires follow with me. They are ever fresh. Desires are ever young. It is not an old desire. Desire is always young. So, that which never becomes old, even though one becomes old, moreover, a disease, that which is a disease, which puts an end to life itself. Pranantika rogaha tan trushnam chajataha sukam. The one who gives up this kind of a trushna, he alone is really happy. Who is happy? The one who gives up this. Therefore, excellent. He says, my dear, purnam varsha sahasram me vishaya sakta chetasah tatapi anudinam drushnaha mamaite shvabhijayate. My dear son, full 1,000 years I enjoyed. Now it is my experience, they never end. They are ever fresh. Therefore, tasmat, what do you know? Tasmad enam aham chaktva. Now, therefore I realize now. I am coming to a point. Chaktva, I will now give up all this. Having given up, having renounced this desire, brahmanyadhayamanasam. Brahmani adhayamanasam. Devoting myself, focusing my mind on Brahman. Supreme Brahman. Nirdvandvo nirmamo bhutva. Cherishyami mrugaisah. I become nirdvandvaha. There is no question of difference now. I drop all the differences. No pairs of opposites. Nirmamaha. And now I will be total nirmama. I become. Not mamata. Nirmama. Then what I do? I become nirmama. I become nirdvandva. Pairs of opposites I give up. I also give up all attachments to this kingdom, body, relatives, everybody. Then what I do? Mrugai saha, along with any animals in a forest, I move along with them. Jungle mein, un sab ke saath mein ghumta rahunga. So badram te, my dear son, let good things happen to you. And you are very happy. Why? Because all my other children never heard me request when I said, give me. You are the one who sacrificed. And therefore, they are not my children. Why? A son is the one who obeys the instructions of the father and serves the father and the mother. Therefore, a puru, I will make you as my successor. Now you are the next. So Yayati called all his ministers and told them, well wishes everybody, that this is now Puru is becoming next. This is what is in my mind. What do you say? They all said, you are right, sir. They approved Yayati's thoughts. Yes, you can make Puru, but he is the only real son for you. Then Yayati had put Puru on the throne. He went to jungle and along with some brahmanas, tapasvi brahmanas, did lot of tapas and he reached heaven. So from Yadu, his son Yadu, Yadavas are born. One son. And Turvasu, Devayani is second son. Through Turvasu, Yavanas are born. Yavana. Germans. German that side. Yavanas are called Yavanas. Sons of Druhya are called as Bhoja. Bhojas you must have heard. Bhojaraja. So Bhoja, Druhya's sons. Mlechas are born from Anu. Anu gave birth to Mlecha Jati. Each of them became an instrument in collecting those kind of jivas of those qualities, instrumental, and through them this mrityajas, Anu mrityajas are born. From Puru only Paurava Vamsha was born. So in the Puru Vamsha, Kuru was born, so Kuru Vamsha also is born, so Paurava Vamsha, in which, O Janamejaya, you are also born in this Paurava Vamsha only, Paurava Vamsha only. Now, Yayati, he did great tapas in the jungle. Yayati's story not ended, eh? Interesting. What did he do? After tapas, he went to heaven. In the tapas, well, during his tapas, you know, he lived almost for 30 years on water, and completely 1 year he did Panchagni tapas. Four sides Agni and also sun on the top, Panchagni, and sitting in the midst of fire doing tapas. There is only one Mahatma who did Panchagni tapas. I saw that Yajnavatika also, Pancha, great Mahatma. He never comes out of the room. So that was tapas he did. So he became like almost like Indra Saman, equal to Indra, in tejas and brilliance, etc. Now he was happily. Indra one day asked him, Beta, Yayati ji, you tell me, what do you to teach Puru when you are leaving the entire kingdom, etc., etc.? What do you to teach him? What kind of upadesha you gave him, Puru? You please tell truth as it is. Then Yayati told, you know, I told him to be how to behave, how anger destroys, how to take care of people, how to uphold dharma. All those things the teachings are given. As it is, he mentioned and repeated. Now Indra again asked him, that is good. You tell me, with whom you are equal in your tapas? In your tapas, with whom you are equal. Wah, this question, when the moment he said, our great Vyayati said, Naham deva manushyeshu gandharveshu maharshishu atmanat tapatatulyam kanchit pashyami vasava. There is nobody equal in my tapas among devatas, manushyas, gandharvas and maharshis. My tapas is so great and nobody can match me in my tapas. Ho gaya ahankar ki baat. But the moment he said, Indra said, Baba, theek hai, with this you no more deserve to stay in heaven, he said. The moment he uttered this statement, Indra said, you no more deserve to stay in heaven. Why? Tatkshana, at that time itself, you have exhausted all your punya. It's a very beautiful subject. I am now concising it. Otherwise, you may be feeling that I am boring, I am dragging. Otherwise, so wonderful it is. So wonderful. Na to aap kehte ki aage badhte nahi story, badhte nahi aage jaate nahi, kya kare? So wonderful. So he said, tasmat lokaha, all these, whatever lokas you achieved now, this kind of heights, they came to an end. Therefore, your punya, kshine punye, Paditasya Agya Rajan. Hey Raja, now you have to fall on earth. Now please go. And he was sent out to heaven. Immediately, there is no sending. Automatically he is drawn towards earth. Towards the lower planes he was drawn. No, Yayati asked, Are Baba, galti to kiya? At least bless me that I fall among sadhu purushas. I must fall among sadhu purushas, among people, good people. Make me fall in that way. That is a beauty thing. Are wah. The moment you are asked this desire, Indra said, okay, at least this blessing I'll give you. You shall fall among sadhu purushas only, but come back to quickly after you make your buddhi proper. Tvam mam amam syaha tadrusha sreyasascha. Edat viditva cha punaha yayate yayate. You will again come back to me. You will fall there and come back to me. Now, he said, again, why did you fall? The one more important point is, you have humiliated. You said there is nobody equal to you in all the three worlds among Gandharvas, Yakshas, Kimpurushas, etc. And therefore, you are not entitled to stay here. And he says, so beautiful, he says, excellent one thing, one of the important things. Yati, Indra says, never dishonor your equals or your elders. If we dishonor our equals and our elders, this is the result. Result is fall. Very wonderful. Therefore, Maharaji, aap jaiye. Then yes, very mystical statements also are there, because he was falling. Anyway, this Surya Bhagavan, the Surya orb sun, is the gateway, only gateway, as Yoga Shastras explained, for Jiva to travel from this loka to other loka, urdhva lokas. The gateway is sun's orb. I am literally telling sun's orb only, they say Yoga Shastras. So you also become Tejo Rupa and pass through the sun's orb and mysteriously enter into a totally higher planes. Not again this plane. It's like a magic thing. You enter and you enter a new world. Not visible world. Through that Surya Marga. That's why Surya Marga and Chandra Marga was told. Surya, that means Uttarayana, Dakshinayana. So the dead ones, if they take up Surya Marga, they are on a higher plane. But very difficult to cross the sun's orb. And Munduka Upanishad comes. Ahuti is what you offer. They alone will take you up to the gateway and hand over you at the checkpost. Ahuti is Leli Yase. Yehi, yehi, iti mantra will come. Please come, please come. This is your punya. And therefore the marga is shown for Jiva and there is no other way. Therefore the fall here, he says, drushtvacha tvam surya pathat patantam. Again, he came from surya patha. Marga surya pathat patantam. Patantam means falling actually. So people saw on the ground some Mahatmas. Everybody saw. They were really deluged. Who is this person coming, falling from heaven through sun's marga on earth? Yayati is falling. Drishva chatvam dishtitam deva marge shakrarka vishnu prativa prabhavam abhyudratastvam vayamadya sarve tatvam prapate tava jignyasamanah. All the jignyasus, all the great people, they started looking at him. And they said, who is this man great? Falling down. And there he was falling amidst a tapasvi raja, a great king by name Ashtaka. Ashtaka saw him falling. Actually, how the fall takes place? If fall takes place, linger in environment, take the physical body and enter into physical body. He is not falling with the gross body, no. And there are yoga rahasyas. They are all yogic secrets. The secret how the he was falling, no doubt about it. Yes, linger in atmosphere for some time and dhoondna padega dusra sharir. But they could see him, Yayati, falling. And therefore, Yayati, I mean, was spotted by this Ashtaka, and Ashtaka immediately asked various questions. Oh Mahatma, you are shining, you are brilliant, you are great. You look like a tapasvi. You are actually radiating your light everywhere. How come you are falling from that height? Where are you falling from? Why are you falling? Who are you? And what is the cause of this fall? And it is believed Yayati was suspended there, and Ashtaka was asking questions and Yayati is answering. This Bhagavatam also we saw Gokarna's brother Dundukari. He was Baba tum hazar baar bhi zahar karo ki mera uddhar nahi hoga kyunki amma mahapapi hai yaar wo bhrata. And the changing colors in Bhagavat Mahatmya mein aata hai sab. Then saptah karaya Bhagavat. Then each day one knot was broken. Actually sapta knots inside. And he is released. Beautiful form like a deva. He gives darshan, thanks his brother and goes to higher planes. So Vivekananda said in one of the conversations. And Vivekananda literature is there. One spirit used to help him. Not that he is depending on useless fellows, everybody, for his information. But that fellow used to tell, yeh ho raha hai, wo ho raha hai, abhi wo aa raha hai. There is lots of information about important things. And Vivekananda, some are true, some are wrong. Then somebody asked, what happened to him? I prayed for him one day, since then he stopped coming. He disappeared. And I have never seen him afterwards, he said. Meaning, his prayer had helped him to go and relieve himself from that plane in which he was caught up. He was released. Vivekananda. So here he was caught. Then, Ashtaka asked so many questions. I am present in a concise form. If you want, you can read. There are 5-6 chapters are there at length. 4 or 5 chapters. Yayati says, never one should become arrogant of wealth. Some points only I am telling you. Where I became arrogant of wealth. Wealth of what? Wealth of punyam also. Tapashakti also is a wealth. All the beings in the creation, so wonderful, are controlled by prarabdha. Sabhi ke sabhi log, prarabdha is controlling us, Vyati says. Therefore, knowing very clearly that prarabdha is stronger, one should not develop any vikara towards either sukha or dukkha. Why? Prarabdha is bringing sukha or dukkha. Therefore, don't develop any vikara. Vikara of jyada bhogna hai sukh milne ke baad. Ye bhi ek vikara hota hai. Ye dukh mujhe nahi chahiye. Isko hata denge. Ye bhi aur ek vikara hota hai. And wise people, Yayati says, wise people consider prarabdha to be more powerful than one's buddhi. Because buddhi hi karma anusarini. Prarabdha is more powerful. Wise people consider than one's own buddhi. Because intelligence itself is conditioned by the vasanas. Therefore, they never get attached to sense objects. So prarabdha vashat, whatever vastus are brought to us for our bhoga or anubhuti, if I hold on to them, I'll be in trouble. Then Yayati says, continues, of course, I'm avoiding questions and all that. Here they say, Ashtaka Maharshi, Maharaj, Ashtaka, you please understand, all those people who unnecessarily they don't know how to handle themselves, they fall on this narakam called Bhaumam Narakam. This is called as Bhaumam Narakam. Bhu Narakam, he said, called as. Yayati says this as Bhaumam Narakam. Who fall on Bhaumam Narakam? Says, those who sing their own glories. Those who beat their own trumpets, blow their own trumpets, they fall in the Bhaumam Narakam and they come to suffer in life, he said. They suffer a lot in life. What is Bhaumam Narakam? Bhaumam Narakam, when he asked a question, I never heard Bhaumam Narakam. I heard other Narakas. What is this Narakam you are referring to? He said, Bhaumam Narakam is nothing but wandering on this earth from birth to death, Bekarame. Naraka only is this. Janam se lekar murchu tak, wandering. The Bhaumam Narakam. Such wandering itself is called Bhaumam Narakam, he said. Vyayati says, we fall on this. And wise people say there are 7 gates to heaven. What are 7 gates? Tapas, Danam, Shama. Shama is control of the mind. Dama is control of Indriyas, Indriya Nigraha. Lajja, that is modesty you can take. Shame should be there. What is modesty? Saralata, that is very straightforward, very simple. Saralata and Daya. These are the 7 gates. Tapaha, Danam, Shama, Dama, Lajja, Saralata and Daya. These 7 are the gates to heaven. Meaning one has to establish at least in any one of them very deeply, very deep rooted. And all the 6 would enjoin the first one. And Ashtaka asked a question. What happens to Jiva after death? Please tell me. Ye kahan kahan jata hai marne ke baad? Aapko dekh ke aa rahe hai sab. Because you have seen Svarga also and you have seen Naraka also. In a sense you are falling also. You have seen enrolled many lokas also, many jivas also. You please tell me now. What will happen? And Ayati says, you know, just like jivas wander, the people wander in dream, in their own dream world. Jivas also wander after death, also is like a dream for them. They keep on wandering. Wander. Where they wander? Wherever the mind takes them, wherever the karma takes them, wherever their papa or punya takes them, you are just like a balloon. Balloon has no independent control, is it not? Balloon is left. Once balloon is released from our hands, it is at the mercy of winds. So similarly, even now also same thing, but then at least we have some purusharatha. Sharira is not there, what purusharatha you can do? In bhoga yoni you enter, for example. What purusharatha you can do? So there is no purusharatha. So Yayati explains that. And Jiva wanders. And who guides him? Karma. Helpless. You are helpless. I cannot have, my will has no control there. Main vahan jana jata hun, but I am going this side. Why I am going this side? I don't know. I am being pulled that side. Helpless our condition. And Yayati says, I don't want to talk more about this. He says, iske bare mein jyada mujhe, I don't want to speak on this for a long time. And Ashtaka along with the brothers also are there. All of them are there. Every one of them offered. Ashtaka asked him, ye bataiye pehle, because you know you are from Devaloka. Right now you are still possessing. The moment you enter into earth atmosphere and enter into body or anything, you may lose all your wisdom. But therefore I am asking you one question before you.
please tell me, what do you think my future is? What kind of punya I gained? Yayati says, for you, the kind of punya you have done, you are going to enjoy a greater, higher planes, higher lokas, there is no doubt about it, they are all waiting for you. Meaning, plane, higher lokas, many lokas, you will enjoy, and that is what you have done punya, and your future is that. The moment Yayati says to Ashtaka, Ashtaka says, I will give all those lokas to you, all the punya to you. You please don't fall, sir. Go back to heaven again. You are a tapasvi. You are a Yayati Raja. You did tapas. You don't deserve this kind of a fall. Prarabdha bringing you. Doesn't matter. Take my punya and go back again. Don't come here. I'll give you. Yayati says, only Brahmanas are allowed to take gifts from others, not Kshatriyas. मैं आपसे कैसे दान ले सकता हूं? धर्म, दैट इज कॉल्ड धर्म. हाँ, मिल गया बकरा, मिल गया लेके जाओ. हाँ हाँ, आई डोंट वॉन्ट. सो आई विल नॉट टेक समबडी एल्सेस पुण्य, लेट मी सफर. सिमिलरली अदर पीपल आर देयर अराउंड हिम. अष्टक के साथ वसुमान, शिवी, दे ऑल्सो ऑफर्ड देयर पुण्य. ऑल ऑफ देम सेड एंड ऑल एवरीबडी. And also other son called Pratardhana. Pratardhana, other boy, other person, Pratardhana, he also offered his help. He asked what are lokas are there. Yaya said, these are higher lokas for you, these are lokas meant for you. No, then you take this, my punya, and go there. He says, no. Then other people say, Vasuman says, please take my punya also. What other lokas are there for me? Yaya says, these are the lokas, punya you gained, you are going to enjoy this. You please take those lokas and go back. Don't come here. He refuses. Shivi says same thing. He refuses. All the four offered, all the four refused. That time, one lady enters there on earth. She was seeing. And she saw Yayati falling. And she instantly recognized him as her own father. She is the daughter of Yayati. Madhavi, her name is. She saw Yayati's father, and immediately she told her children, four of them, the great kings, great, they are doing yajna yaga adi karmas. She told all the four, bete, he is my father, that is your grandfather. And immediately Vasuman said, ma, aapne suna, he lost all his punya, he is falling from heaven now. And she was really unhappy about this daughter. मेरे पापा को ऐसा हुआ? Then she says, you please take my punya. And then she says, daddy, you have every right on your putri and dauhutri, that is grandsons. And grandchildren are, daughter's sons are your sons only. They have every right to lift you up. ऐसा करके, all the four children, they gave their tapashakti, their punya to Shyati. And because of their act, they also punya, they became, ultimately all of them went back. And Yayati told, ho, today I am really redeemed from this suffering again by my own grandchildren. Karke, all of them with grandchildren, Yayati went back to heaven. This is the story of Yayati. So a lot of details are there. See how many pages I'm flipping. So many things, so many sokala, slokas, so many dharma points are there in this discussion, of course, which we are not seeing, but we concisely we saw what is about it. Now, Janamejaya asks a question to Vaishampayana. Sir, now, oh Vaishampayanji, now please tell me in detail about Puru Vamsa. You told Yayati son, Puru, from Puru only Pauravas are born. We belong to Pauro Vamsha only. Amar Vamsha ke baare mein jada jada dena. Dada, paradada, dada ke dada, dada ke dada. Our Vamsha, you please explain. Now again I'm concising it. But just listen. He details how the Puru Vamsha came now. Somewhere down the line, from Puru, down the line, there was a king by name, down the line. I'm not confusing you, because each king has four or five children.
And the eldest son only becomes the king. And he has four or five children. And the eldest son alone becomes king. So we have to take only one line only. So down the line somewhere, there was a king called Eli. He married Ratantari. And Eli and Ratantari, Dushyanta was born. So Ratantari Visa, Dushyanta was born. And Dushyanta is eldest. She got five sons total. Shura, Bhima, Pravasu and Vasu. They are all other four children. Dushyanta eldest. Now, since Dushyanta eldest, he became the king. Now Dushyanta's son was Bharata. Bharata ruled. Bharata had nine sons. He had three wives. And he, the moment nine sons were born, one of them, as a children only, he was not happy. And he came to a conclusion that none of them are fit for becoming the king. So Bharata's wives got angry. Three of them got angry. They were not happy. So they killed all nine children. She killed. Bekarma janam liya karke. So Bharata, through the grace of Bharadwaja Rishi, another son he got by name Bhumanyu. Bhumanyu. His name is Bhumanyu. So Bhumanyu became the king after Bharata. Bhumanyu's eldest son was Suhotra. Suhotra. And he became the king. I'm just cutting it short. Only one line I'm taking also. And Suhotra's eldest son was Ajameda. Ajameda, he became the king. Now Ajameda's sons were again Dushyanta, Parameshti. Not original Dushyanta because the names are repeated again. Tradition is Dada ka naam laga toh aur kya? Paradada ka dada ka naam. You see come across Dushyanta, Dhritarashtra, Janamejaya, Bhimasena. So many names are coming in between future also. Before Pandavas, these names were many times repeated. They are not specially given. Dhritarashtra, before in Kuru Vamsha, Dhritarashtra is not first Dhritarashtra. Earlier to that, there was another Dhritarashtra. And Ajameda's sons were Dushyanta and Parameshti. They both were called as Panchalas. One of the, they separated. Now, Samvarana was also a grandson of Ajameda through another son, Ruksha. Ruksha was the son of Ajameda through Ruksha. This person was born, Samvarana. King Samvarana was born. Now, Samvarana, when he was ruling the earth, it is mentioned in Mahabharata, there was a huge loss of population on earth. Bar-bar hote rehta hai. Population swells and big calamities come, population nashta ho jata hai. That is divine plan. So you and I don't have to worry about it. Hum yadi tik tik se rahe, jeevan jiye to bas kaafi hai. If you are not becoming liable to society around, it's a great bet. And if you do what we are supposed to do every day, morning till evening, that is the greatest contribution to the peace of the mind and to the country's prosperity. And that is real patriotism. Everybody works their own duties properly. Patriotism, that there comes the patriotism. Anyway, Samvarana, when he was ruling, as I told you, lot of loss of. And Panchalas waged a war against Samvarana. Samvarana was ruling Kurujangala area. This area only. Panchal is above that. So, and Panchal attacked Samvarana. Samvarana lost and he went to somewhere near Afghanistan side and he hid himself on a parvata with all his ministers and all. And Vasishthiji grace, through Vasishthiji help, again he got back his kingdom, driven away the Panchalas again back those times, and then again. At that time only, the story in detail we see later on, Samvarana married daughter of Surya Bhagavan called Tapati. That story we see later on. Exhaustively it comes. So Tapati and Samvarana. So Tapati gave birth to a son by name Kuru.
So from Bharata, Dushyanta, Bharata, Ila, so many back again. Puru to, again we came up to Kuru. Now he became very popular because of his Dharma Buddhi, and entire area named after him called Kuru Jangala. Kuru Kshetra, Kuru Jangala. Kuru Jangala is a forest region of the Kurukshetra. Kurukshetra is a civilian place. Jangala is the jungle, actually. Forest region. That Brahmatara, which we have it in Kurukshetra, that was very, very, very big, maybe 20, 30 times bigger 5,000 years back. And that was same water, as Mahatma said, same water was used during the Kurukshetra fight for everybody. Cooking, Dhanakarya, to the Dakshina side, their entire bodies were cremated. For cooking, for taking bath, for Tarpana, for Dhanakarya, all the Pani was used that much only, Brahmatar, which is still there in Kurukshetra. It was too big at that time. So that place, south, the southern side to Brahmasar, and other side is Kurukshetra, down southern side is Kurujanga, forest area. So because of this became very popular, and Kurujangala named after him, and Kurukshetra came. And Kurukshetra, he made that Kshetra more pavitra through his dharma karyas. Many yajnas, yagas, good things he performed. He performed tapas. So entire Kshetra became, therefore Dharma Kshetre, Kuru Kshetre. Why it is called Dharma Kshetra? Because Kuru had lived like that. The entire place was filled with Yajna Yagadi Karmas. So Kuru had five sons. Who are they? Aśvamedhika, Abhishyanta, Chatraratha, Muni, and Janamejaya. Janamejaya again, not this Janamejaya. I told you names are, same names again are kept to have their children. Now, Aśvamedhika or Avikshit, the other names also, are both same. One among them is, Aśvamedhika had sons, too many sons. One among Aśvamedhika's son is Parikshit, not this Parikshit, again. Other name. So Parikshit had seven sons. This Janamejaya, another son of Kuru, he had many sons, and his eldest son is Dhritarashtra. Not this Dhritarashtra, earlier Dhritarashtra. And other sons are Pandu, Bakulika, Nishada, Jambunada, Kundodara, Padati, and Vasati. And Vasati is the eighth one. So Dhritarashtra is the eldest, so he became the king. Not this Dhritarashtra, that somewhere we are behind. And grandson of Kuru, that is grandson of Kuru, is the eldest son of Janamejaya's son. So Kuru, Janamejaya, Dhritarashtra, it came like that. Then Dhritarashtra had many sons. Out of them, only three became popular. Out of Dhritarashtra's sons, many sons, three became popular. Who are they? One is Pratipa, Dharmanetra, and Sunetra. Pratipa, Dharmanetra, and Sunetra. Among these three, Pratipa is more popular. Pratipa had three sons. Devapi, Shantanu, Bakulika. Now we are entering Shantanu Maharaj again. This Devapi is considered as a great Maharshi also. Devapi, he left the world, in the sense of the kingdom, not the world, and went for tapas. Never returned. He is a master, the spiritual master, is considered as a spiritual master. He left. And therefore Shantanu became, second son Shantanu became the king. And his brother also, Bahulika also ruled the kingdom. Maybe share the kingdom, some part here, some part, Shantanu. So thus, Janamejaya, I mean Vaishampayana says, Kaurava kings were, they all of them were great and splendorous. They were splendorous meaning very, very majestic, gigantic, tejasvi. That is their story. Now, why Shantanu is called as Shantanu? One very wonderful shloka comes here. In 95th chapter, 46th shloka, page number 291. Usme yah diya gaya, yam yam karabhyam sprashati jirnam sa sukham ashtute. Arre vah, Shantanu Maharaj, jis bade bhule logon ko हाथ लगाते हैं ना स्पर्श करते हैं इमीडिएट दे यूज्ड टू गेट शांति आई बिलीव यम यम कराभ्याम स्पृशति जीर्णम स सुखम अश्नुते पुनः युवाच भवति अगेन ऑल द ओल्ड पीपल एज नीवर दी प्रशांत महाराज टचस देम दे यूज्ड टू फील वेरी शांति एक्सपीरियंस पीस एंड ऑल्सो फील दे आर बिकेम यंग नाउ यूथ. Therefore, tasmat tam shantanum viduhu. Therefore, he became shantanu. Not shantanu, shantanu. Shantanu means body, no? Shanti. So, shantanu he became. So, great. Anybody when we touch, they should experience that kind of a thing. And therefore, iti tad asya shantanutvam. So this is the cause or reason for calling him as Shantanu. Now this Shantanu, of course it comes up to Shantanu married Ganga. Vamsha is telling, no, Janamejaya, Vaishampayana is telling to Janamejaya. Shantanu married Ganga. She gave birth to Bhishmacharya, of course. Then Shantanu also married Satyavati, then gave birth to Chitrangada and Vichitravirya. We will see Chitrangada was killed by Gandharva. Very for a funny reason, he was killed by Gandharva. For no reason. Reason is what? One Gandharva came across Chitrangada. He said, Are, tera naam Chitrangada hai? Mera naam bhi Chitrangada hai. Tu mera naam kyo lagaya tum? To yuddh karo, bola. Kyo yuddh karna? देखो तेरा मेरा नाम बदनाम नहीं होना चाहिए. चित्रांगद वीर पावरफुल. मैं साथ युद्ध करो. तू जीत ले तो तू रखना. मैं जीत ले तो मैं रखता हूं. उस युद्ध में बेग बेचारा वो मारा गया. चित्रांगद का फियर्स बैटल ही वाज ही फॉट अल्टीमेटली हैड टू लूज. सो विचित्र वीर्य बिकेम किंग. नाउ विचित्र वीर्य मैरिड अगेन. यू नो स्टोरी विल कम ऑफ कोर्स अंबिका एंड अंबालिका. And the story continues. Vaishampayana tells then how total 5 Pandavas but 11 sons they had. And among all the sons of Pandavas, eldest is Ghatotkacha. Bade putra. Sabse bada is Ghatotkacha. He's eldest. And Bhima was the first one who married among all the 5. That story we will see later on. Vayega. So then up to till Janamejaya, that is the king, Vaishampayana tells, Ah Maharaj, Pura Vamsha ka pata ke, ye yahan tak abhi hai. Karke rok dete wahan. Now, Vaishampayana says, now the story begins. Ab Shantanu story. We are entering now, Mahabharata. You have been waiting, no? Ye kab Pandav log aayenge, kab Pandav log aayenge, kab kahani shuru hoga, kab kahani shuru hoga, baap re. अभी शांतनु महाराज आए आफ्टर ऑलमोस्ट सो मेनी आदि पर्व इज थर्ड मंथ आई थिंक द स्टडी यस थर्ड मंथ ना यस थर्ड यज्ञ ऑन आदि पर्व अभी तक हुआ नहीं. वो कहाँ होगा? बहुत बड़ा लंबी है ये तो. नाउ देयर यूज्ड टू बी अ किंग बाय नेम महाभिष. स्टोरी लिखते जाओ. This Mahābhārata, such a great king, he did a great tapas and he went to Svargārohaṇa. Mahābhārata. One day what happened? There was a meeting in Brahmaloka. So sare devata log vahan se Brahmaloka gaye meeting attend karne. So Brahmaji was there. Sabhi log, they were sitting around Brahmaloka. That time, many ancient kings, not out from the earth, those who have reached heaven, but great tapasvins, great kings, they also reached, and Mahabhisha also is one among them who went to Brahmaloka. And there they were all sitting around, surrounding Brahmaji. There came Gangaji also. And the wind came and Gangaji's clothes just were off. When all the Sabhā people, Brahmaloka Vasis, they closed their eyes, Mahābhārata looked at Gangaji and lost in her beauty. That time, Brahmaji got angry. Tuchha manav, murkha mandabuddhi, manone mandabuddhe, durmate. Brahmaloka is not the place for kama. Yadi, that's the reason why Vedanta says, aap Brahmaloka tak bhi jayenge, वहां से भी गिर जाएंगे. इसीलिए वेदांत से दे नो ब्रह्मलोक आल्सो. व्हाई? लोक इटसेल्फ इज ए बॉन्डेज. हमारा अखंडानंद महाराज कहते थे कि ब्रह्मलोक आप जाओगे, वहां पे ब्रह्मा जी एक दिन बुला के, बेटा पृथ्वी पर जाओ, थोड़ा झाड़ू मार के आओ, तो आपको आना पड़ेगा झाड़ू मारने, माने कुछ प्रवचन देने महाभारत पर. तो उतरना पड़ता है ऊपर से, हमारा हाथ में कोई नहीं है. जाओ बेटा झाड़ू मार के आओ, थोड़ा झाड़ू मार के आओ, अखंडा महाराज कहते थे. तो झाड़ू मारने लोग आते हैं. सो वो भी बंद है, बंधकार, बंधकारकम, बंधन. बस द मोमेंट यू डोंट डिजर्व, इट सेज नाउ यू आर रियली make a very bad. So therefore you shall take birth as a human being, go. Because manushyo mein aise kama, uncontrolled kama, uncontrolled anger, it is a manushya jati diseases. You deserve that only, because jaise vasana vaise upadhi. You don't deserve this upadhi now, go. And because Gangaji also stole your heart, she will also come with you. She has really charmed you, so she has to, but in Bhūloka, she will act against your wish. Go. So Mahābhārata was depressed. He has to come down. So process of coming down started. Jaisa garbh mein shishu bahar aane ke liye kam se kam 9-10 mahine lenge, waise hi utarna bhi thoda aasan nahi hai. Zing karke wahi utarte dheere 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 dheere. उतरते उतरते बहुत समय हो जाएगा, मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस. सो एंड गंगा जी ऑल्सो वॉज अनहैप्पी इन द सेंस, शी सेड नॉट अनहैप्पी, वॉट एवर वॉज कर्स कर्स ओके. शी वॉज कमिंग एंड शी सॉ एंड रूट वसुगणास, अष्टवसुस. अष्टवसुस ऑल्सो वर पेल, डिप्रेस्ड, एंड दे आर ऑल्सो इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ कमिंग डाउन. गंगा जी आस्क्ड देम, ए आप लोग ऐसे क्यों हैं? What happened to you? Ashtavasu said, Amma Gangamaya, we were cursed by Vasishtha Rishi to take birth on earth. Kyon? Hum log gaye unka kau kamadhenu apaharan kiye. That story again will come later on details. To isliye kya hua? We were cursed. We have to take birth on earth now. So kindly please do one favor to us. You become our mother. Why? We cannot take birth in any ordinary woman's womb. Manushya lok mein, ordinary stree ke garbh mein hamara pravesh nahi ho sakta. Aur ek baat hai. Aap se Ganga ji asked, who can be your father? They said, Shantanu, he will be born. Who is Shantanu? Mahābhārata. He will be born And otherwise, we cannot take birth now. In everybody's woman, womb, we cannot enter. So, Vasugana said, he will be your father. Gangaji said, okay, I will become your mother. But now, Vasugana said, one more time, oh Gangaji, you are the one who flows not only on earth, in all three worlds your presence is there. इस लोक में इस रूप में प्रकट हो रही है पंचमहाभूतास ओनली सृष्टि इज मेड अप ऑफ एनी आई कांट रिपीट ऑल दैट अगेन सो शी इज देयर इन ऑल थ्री वर्ल्ड्स नाउ यू डू वन थिंग टू अस एज सून एज वी आर बॉर्न यू प्लीज किल अस व्हाई वी कैन क्विकली कम बैक टू अवर लोक गंगा जी सेड ओके बट देन आई मस्ट लीव एटलीस्ट वन चाइल्ड फॉर शांतनु को मार कम से कम एक को छोड़ना पड़ेगा देन वसु सेड ओके एट वन यू लीव हिम एंड ही विल बी सपोर्टेड बाय अवर तेजस आल्सो बट ही विल बी बिकम वेरी फेमस बट ही विल नॉट मैरी आप कृपा करके शी गेव वर्ड एज सून एज यू आर बॉर्न आई विल पुट यू इन वाटर एंड आई विल थ्रो यू इन वाटर एंड आई विल किल यू देन यू विल बी रिलीव्ड फ्रॉम द this curse and go back to your Vasuloka instantly except the 8th one. So Gangaji spoke, Vasuganas were very happy and they all went to their abodes. In a sense they are preparing now, come back. They are not happy. Transfer order mil gaya, transfer abhi karna hona hai, saman pack karna hona laga, aisa hota hai. You are not interested in them, but transfer order to aa gaya. Order aane ke baad kya kar sakte hain? फिर लोग पूछते कब जा रहे हैं वैसे वसुलोक में सब लोग पूछने लगे उनको कब जा रहे हैं कब जा रहे हो आपको पृथ्वी पर जाना है कब जा रहे हो सो दैट इज अ वेरी पेनफुल थिंग ना वैशम पायना कंटिन्यूज सो दैट आफ्टर सम टाइम किंग प्रतिपा वॉज रूलिंग द लैंड प्रतिपा वी सी ऑलरेडी वी सॉ हिज नेम हिज सन इज शांतनु दैट टाइम प्रतिपा ऑल्सो वॉज एंगेज इन ग्रेट तपस इट्स ऑल हिस्ट्री हैपेंड ऑन अर्थ Only thing is, we can't understand because science and technology, this is the age. That time, we had those kind of technologies that science, mantra, yoga, we saw it. Those details are absent nowadays. So time is so fast, 5,000 years, 6,000 years, 7,000 years, 10,000 years, we speak about cosmic history. We speak what is happening behind the curtain also. That is the Vyasa Bhagavan's grace. We are always studying the history. Even now some Mahatmas are born behind the curtain. What kind of arrangements are going on, we don't know. Like Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Vivekananda ji, they always tell a story. Story means it happened. But Ramakrishna Paramahamsa himself told this. What did he say? I was a child in Tapoloka. A great Rishi was meditating, I believe, in Dhyana Avastha, Tapoloka. And there was one crawling boy, went and woke him up. The Rishi opened. Why are you disturbing me? The child said, No, hum log purthvi par jana, tum mere saath aa jao. And the child is Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, that Rishi was Vivekananda. In Tapolok mein, that Bala Roopa mein, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was going there. And their order came. So Ramakrishna Paramahamsa brought Vivekananda. Dekho Vivekananda, I am waiting for you, intezaar kar raha hun tere liye. Itna late kyun kiya? And Vivekananda, after leaving the body, he met another Mahatma in Bangalore. After leaving the body, he went and said, I spat my body just now, he said. Phew! Karke chod ke aaya shareer ko. He was telling that Mahatma there. After leaving the body, he went there, I just now spat my body. So even today, what is happening behind the screen, we are blind. Because we are very much interested in on the screen. What is happening? Such as movie, television screen. We are interested in these useless screens. Even today, there are great arrangements are going on. Mahatmas are coming. Big arrangement it is. Big plan it is. Hum log andhe hain. Andha, andha. Bah. Thick darkness we are in. Even today, these things are happening. But even today, the time, as long as Srishti is there, the show behind the curtain, the planning behind the curtain keeps on taking place. We are only blind to his game, his leela. So Pratipava doing tapas. One day, as he was doing tapas, a young lady came. So beautiful. She sat on his right thigh, Pratipa's right thigh. And that lady said, "Please marry me." He said, "Dear, I cannot marry anybody like that. Who are you? Why did you sit on my thigh now? I am engaged in tapas." She said, "Don't ask me, I am like a Devakanya only, but you marry me." He said, "No. Since you sat on my right thigh is a place for a son, daughter, or a son, daughter-in-law. Son, or a daughter, or a daughter-in-law. This is a place, right thigh. Left thigh is for a place for wife. You chose and sat on a right thigh, so I can never treat you as my wife. At the most, you can become my daughter-in-law." She said, "Okay, I'll accept the proposal. But your son, I will come and meet him. I will marry him, your son. But one thing, he should not ask me about my details. Who am I? He should not ask. Where am I from? He should not ask. And whatever I do, he should not object. These are the conditions." And Pratipa also did not ask, "Who are you?" He said, "Okay, you meet my son when he grows, when he is born, when he grows, when he becomes a youth. When you happen to meet him, okay, I will tell my son at that time." After some time, a son was born to Pratipa. Mahābhiṣa took birth as a son to Pratipa and he became Śāntanu. Now Śāntanu, since his birth, his nature was of Śānta Svabhava. Śānta Svabhava. And this is another reason why he is called as Śāntanu. Now, when he became young, Yuvavastha pahunch gaye, Pratipa told, "Beta, mere baat suno. Now you became youth. Sometime afterwards, when you are hunting or any time, one lady will come to you." An entire conversation he told, what he had with that lady earlier. "And don't ask these questions, who are you? Where are you from? And whatever she does, sahan lena. She is the only fit, she wanted to marry you, she will marry you. Simply marry her, don't ask any other questions." Śāntanu said, "Okay." Having instructed his Śāntanu, his son, he made him sit on the throne and Pratipa went to forest for tapas. So Pratipa will never come again. He left. Now Śāntanu was ruling. Wonderful. One day as he was hunting, there he saw Gangaji. But he doesn't know she is Ganga. The beauty is he doesn't know at all. He saw one lady there. What happened? Tomorrow. So, aapse kahani kahani. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Guru Bhyo Namaha. Hari Om Sat Gurunath Maharaj Ki.